Hello, I'm Liz Lumley of Finextra, and today I'm speaking to Giuliano Fronzarelli, Wolfgang Wanger, and Dean Spesito, all of Deutsche Bank. So, you know, the three of you all cover clients in the EMEA region, all but in different sub-regions. So I kind of wanted to start off our discussion looking at, you know, the latest developments in your markets and what your clients are looking for. So, Giuliano, I wanted to start with you to give us some details.
Thank you, Liz, for the question. Look, you have mentioned the region is South Europe. I'm covering is a lot of stuff going on, so I will just briefly touch that. But basically what we see is, look, in our region, where we concentrate and where we see a lot of client demand really is partnership banking. And then we see consolidation going on. Why? Because people want to work with fewer providers and fly to quality, right? So these are not new themes, but these are themes which we see emerging further and further. And specifically lately, the Cyprus crisis, of course. The Cyprus crisis presents a lot of opportunities and challenges. The challenge really is because overnight you have a lot of uncertainties. All banks are in the same boat. Nobody knows what to do. Nobody understands what the issues and the implications are. So where do we come into play? I think for Deutsche Bank and CMFI specifically, but also the entire bank, our business line is extremely important because we are the holder of the relationships. So our job basically is to support internal crisis management by, you know, interacting with the regulators, with the central banks, with the banks in the country, why they are all under stress. We are under stress, and what you need to do is you need to find out where the obstacles are and try to find out solutions. This is very important that we do this because Deutsche Bank is systemic relevant. So the regulators, the BaFin, the Fed, all the other regulators are talking to us consistently and they want to know how do you deal with this. And in addition, all the clients we have, whether this is EMEA or even globally, they have no clue what's going on. And so what we do is, with this approach, we actually coach them. We can give them information which we obtain internally to help them dealing with this process. This is really what it relates to: personal contact, relationship, long-standing relationship, having access to all the senior guys, and basically substantiating the competence which we have in this business. This is why people trust us and they give us their business. We are not just there to ask for business, but we support them in all kind of aspects.
Yeah, no, I agree. I mean, I think what happened in Cyprus was a bit of a shock, and you know, the customers are looking to their banks for trust for what, you know, what to do in those type of situations. Yeah. So yeah, do you want to go, what's going on in your region?
In 2012 and early 2013, the key theme that I've seen is a significant shift in the competitor landscape. Several competitors were struggling specifically with risk management issues, while others were struggling with this overall situation of increasing costs, pressure on revenues, and at the same time capped investment budgets. And what this has done is it has forced several providers to basically change their coverage models and to reduce their footprint in the market by withdrawing from a number of FI customers and by withdrawing from a number of countries, specifically in the emerging parts of Europe, Middle East, Africa.
Okay.
What this has done essentially is it has triggered a change in the mindset of customers who now realize that it's not only about who will be able to offer the best product and service, which is of course absolutely critical, but it is even more than that. The question is even which provider is going to be with a specific customer in a specific market and in this business, say 5 years down the road. And then when they look towards Deutsche Bank, they see a transaction bank that has done essential things right on the risk management side, on the cost control side, or on the investment side. This has allowed basically Deutsche Bank to stay the course and to be a reliable partner for the financial institutions in the region. Clients appreciate that, and so they have awarded us again with good business in 2012 and 2013.
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned, you know, people pulling out of certain regions and risk management concerns. I mean, you're seeing sort of, are people very anxious right at the moment?
Yes, because it is quite a shift when you realize that while transaction banking is a business that is going to stay, that in your specific market that you are in, or you specifically concerned as a customer, mm-hmm. it might really be something that is being moving away from you. It changes your longer term perspective, and you really want to think about, you know, who are those banks, the providers that are going to be there longer term, mm-hmm. and specifically with me in my emerging market, with me as an institutional customer. And yes, that creates some anxiety on the one hand side, but it also creates some shift to a much more strategic approach towards, as Giuliano said, you know, who am I partnering with?
Mm, exactly. So, Dean, do you want to round us off on this regional outlook?
Sure. Yeah. I mean, if I look at my region, I'll hit maybe a couple topics. My region, I think it's quite heterogeneous. So it's tough to kind of tar it with one brush. We have on the eastern side of the region, because of the, and Giuliano mentioned actually, some of the consolidation issues that happened ensuing from the financial crisis and then the economic crisis, you have banks looking very carefully at their business models and actually having to ask themselves who they are, what they are, and there's a huge need for focus. On the more western part of my region, you've got banks, even by EU decree, that are being pulled more into a national focus, that have to also redesign their business models and actually focus on their core competencies. That changes very much the way they work with correspondent banks, with service providers, and again, goes into the consolidation theme, where they're saying, you know, we can't be everything to everyone. The whole model we used to run with huge amounts of Nostro accounts is really no longer kind of the flavor of the day. We don't need it anymore. And then to Wolfgang's point, you know, we certainly have a consistency, a track record, a stability, and a real focus on this business. And we can show that in various ways, but the truth is, you know, that really has worked to our benefit. Mm-hmm. And we've been a beneficiary of the consolidation process. Now, the only thing that I would add to that is it doesn't happen by accident. So the whole strategy around the market and then consolidating the market is something we've been driving. And that's something that, you know, all three of us have been very, I think, aligned on and working together on is really driving consolidation.
Exactly.
And that's worked, I would say, quite well over the last years for us.
Okay, so it seems like consolidation, emphasis on risk management, collaboration, that seems to be almost a common theme across EMEA right at the moment.
That's correct.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, I would say that. I would also say that's one of those universal themes across our region.
Really, the world of relationship, you know, relationship yes. in its real sense is you only sense this when you're very close. And basically, what for us, it's important that it is a relationship which is consistent and which continues. Mm. Right? And I think that is, you can only foster trust by providing this kind of feeling to the client, which means you're there when the sun shines, but you're there also when you have some fog and you have some some rain and hail, right? So we all had all of these events that these, you sense this back.
That topic of relationship banking leads me into my next question. And this is this idea of there might be a bit of a disconnect between what banks are offering their clients and what clients are looking for. And, you know, there was a recent study conducted by the Boston Consulting Group which said that transaction banking clients want, you know, accurate execution of transactions, of course, and sure. and high service levels rather than new, fancy, new customized products. While banks, you know, really, they're always trying to put out new products to attract customers. So, I mean, is there this mismatch between what clients want and what banks want? I mean, you know, what is your view on that, Dean?
A mismatch, in my opinion, can only occur if you're not listening to your clients. Mm-hmm. So if we start right from there, the most important thing is to know what your client wants. So if we look at an area like customer service, well, let me make one point perhaps before that.
Okay.
We can get into what's happening over the industry. And I know Wolfgang also mentioned the regulatory and the risk profiles. That's changed the dynamic of investment spend. So I always make a distinction between a mandatory spend and a discretionary spend. So a mandatory spend is just the cost of doing business. And that has increased. With the financial crisis, the economic crisis, with the issues out there, the overall spend a bank has is obviously limited. So it can be that you're only spending on the mandatory side and you don't even have really the pockets to look at their discretionary side and really invest in things like customer service, or if you do have some leftover, maybe you're investing incorrectly. I think if we look at customer service, that's an area I would say that Deutsche Bank has got very right. Mm-hmm. And I would say it's a technology and a people-driven piece of what we do. The technology piece connects our clients with our systems. It connects our customer service officers who are located in 29 countries, speaking multiple languages, close to their clients. It connects them with each other and with their clients. And if I can make an example, if we have a US dollar payment from China to Brazil, a Chinese importer is buying coffee in US dollar, there's a problem with the payment. This really works, that our colleague in China, let it be Shanghai or Beijing, can really send a message to his or her colleague in São Paulo, in Brazil, and they all know their respective banks, they've built relationships, and at the end of the day, Elizabeth, you know, there's the technology side, but when we get to these types of issues, it's a people-driven business. Mm. So if you have a relationship with someone at a beneficiary bank or at an ordering bank, you speak their language, you can get things done much differently, much more quickly, much more efficiently, and also really satisfy our clients. And maybe just one more point before I hand over. I started with saying that if you listen to your clients, there should not be this mismatch. This is something I would say is universal over our whole region and globally. Our clients demand the highest level in customer service. We've heard that again and again, and we don't have that mismatch because we know that's what they want. We know that's what they need. They want to give their clients the best service possible. And I think we've really given a lot of attention to that, and I would say done a very good job.
Yeah, I mean, would you want to add to that, Wolfgang?
Yes, I think what is important to what Dina said is to understand that customer service is not just a convenience factor. Yes, if you have an issue to solve, it's absolutely good for you if you have a local contact who speaks the local language who you can contact, but it is even more than that. We have outstanding STP rates, but no bank in this industry is ever going to reach a 100% mark. And we work very closely with our clients on collectively driving the STP rates further up. But at the same time, it is absolutely essential how we work with our customers on those remaining payments that need manual intervention, because there might well include some very critical payments that need to be handled. So the point I'm making is that when we listen to our FI customers, what we hear is that they have an increased competition in their local markets for their key corporate and their key retail customers. And that is why it is critical for them to be able to offer the best customer service to them. And this is exactly where then the Deutsche Bank customer service teams step in, and when they assist our FI clients with the solving of critical issues for their key customers in a professional and speedy manner, then this is much more than a convenience factor. As I said, it becomes a critical key competitive differentiator for the FI clients of us.
Yeah, I think both of you have made this point about this, you know, a lot of the FI clients and are dealing, they have domestic relationships with the banks, but they're in a global business, so they need sort of that global platform to have the domestic relationship. So I'll move on to you. I mean, do you think it's maybe maintaining very high levels of customer service is an ongoing process, and it doesn't get you the newspaper headlines like a new product would? I mean, is that maybe why, not talking about Deutsche Bank, but in the industry in a whole, sometimes there is that mismatch between what customers want, what banks would deliver?
I look at it the following way. The client always has the wish list. We have our wish list. I think partnership means that you can put those together so that for both, the proposition at the end of the day is beneficial. That is a long-standing relationship. In regard to customer service, well, I would quantify this a little bit in the following way. The customer service is our foundation upon which we are building a tower. If the foundation is not strong, the tower, as high as you want to build, is collapsing, so it will not stay. Mm. Look at this from this point of view. I think then that explains a little bit what kind of a role this plays. Customer service is very important. Why? It's the first contact. It's the business card of the bank. A personal contact and local presence is essential, that when you deal with a client, you take ownership. very important. You just don't pass this on to somebody else. You own the problem because you own the client, and you make sure that we get the resolution, and this is being communicated back to the client. So he sees that he gets the VIP service, which he wants, because at the end of the day, you only survive with top quality. Top quality you can define, you know, by technology and products, whatever you have. A client is calling you, he only calls you if he needs your support, right? And we are happy, you know, if we have from time to time a problem, or the client thinks that he has a problem, right? Because that is the only way and one of the best ways how to differentiate from the competition. And the clients will not forget that. Banking, at the end of the day, is a personal business.
That's great. Thank you very much, all three of you. Thank you, Dean, Wolfgang, Giuliano. Thanks.